Welcome to Science Tour online classes.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Welcome to all of you once again to the physics classes. Dear students, we were talking about work, energy and power, and in that lot of the topics we have already discussed, right? So what are the topics we have discussed? We have discussed that potential energy, kinetic energy, the spring force, the variable force, conservative force, all those things. Today in this session, some of the important topic, or some of we may say it is derivation, or we may say it is some of the we are going to arrive a result. Okay, so that is the thing. Okay, so there is nothing but based on conservation of mechanical energy and the total forces. I am giving you a scenario in such a way that, say for example, pendulum, you know, this is nothing but a metal bob is connected, tied to the string, and it is fixed like this. Now if we give a small push here, what happens? It goes and come back and oscillates. No, now means what you have given? You have given some velocity, kinetic energy. You have given some velocity. Velocity you have given, so kinetic energy it will get. Now little more force if you give means it just may go here and come back and will oscillate and will stop. Now what is my question is, I have to give a maximum I can give, maximum any velocity I can give. Maximum velocity I will give means it will rotate like this, and it may rotate like this, and it will oscillate in this way, and it will stop. Now my question is, what must be the minimum velocity that I have to give so it will just complete one rotation? It just complete one rotation. What is that minimum velocity I have to give? That is what we are going to talk about in this class. Okay. Now I don't think so that it looks as if like a circle, but imagine this is a circle, this is a center whose length is L. What are the forces acting here? This is having mass m, so mg will be here. Since it is tied to the string, you have a force that is tension. Now in the equilibrium, the tension is balanced with mg, so remains constant. If suppose weight was more, tension was not sufficient to hold on, it may get cut, right? Now it is not like that, it is balanced. Okay, so I think that okay, I am going to draw a new diagram so that we can understand in a better way. So the same thing I am going to write down, okay, in this way. Okay, so what we have studied, that is nothing but a center, a body mass m. Okay, the two forces, one is mg, another one is tension, the length is L. Now I will consider this point as A, this point as B, and this point as C, and I want you to find out the minimum velocity for the object to move in a vertical circle. This is a vertical circle, no? This is a horizontal circle. I will tie a stone and I will rotate like this. That is a horizontal circle. I will tie a stone and I will rotate like this. That is vertical circle. No, there are different applications in day-to-day life we are using for the vertical circle. That I am going to come later. because before we understand this, okay. Now, what it is this? What is this? Okay. So, this is the thing, no? Now, I will give minimum velocity in such a way that it just comes and reaches here and falls back. There is a minimum. Maximum means any rotation it may take. The minimum means the minimum velocity needed. So, I will write down here the minimum velocity is VA. The velocity here it is VB. The velocity here it is VC, right? So, the place A, what all we can write down? At place A, at point I am going to write down. So, what is the heading you have to write down? That is a question for you, no? The heading you can write down, motion of the object in a vertical circle. Motion of the object in a vertical circle. So, at point A, the total energy is what? The total energy itself is kinetic energy, no? The total energy itself is kinetic energy. There is no potential energy. So, that is half m V A square. That is half m V A square. That is potential energy. Okay. That is point A. Now, point C. At point C, what happens? It will lift it to this height. It is having some potential energy as well as kinetic energy at point C, right? At point C, it is having some potential energy as well as kinetic energy. So, how we can write down? Because that object is moves here and comes back, no? The potential energy plus kinetic energy. So, for energy at C, which is equal to half m v c square plus m g 2 l, no? This is l, this is l, 2 l. Now, object is here means it is lifted to this and it is having both kinetic energy as well as potential energy. The net force at C, the net force at C, what you can write down? The net force at C, that is using laws of motion chapter, we are going to write down net force which is equal to M into A, isn't it? So, M into A means what? There is a force, isn't it? There is an acceleration when the object is moving in a circular motion. That is nothing but centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration means what? V square by R. But F is equal to ma. No? That is centripetal forces means m into V square by R. That is centripetal acceleration. No? So, here the net force is nothing but only one that is acting here mg, and tension is 0 here. Tension is 0 because it slackens that string. It will go, if string is tight, there is a tension. If it is loose, there is no tension. Suppose there is an object, see, tightly held means tension is there. Now, it is in this way means there is no tension. Now, what happens? This object goes to the upper end. Upper end it will go, it becomes loose, means there is no tension in the string. So, the net force is nothing but mg, okay. So, you can write down the net force at C, that is net force is mg plus T is equal to m v square by R, but T is 0, okay, T is 0. So, that is nothing but mvc square by R, no? Okay, mvc square by R, because at C we are writing. So, mvc square by R. So, you can write down, now this is equation 1, this is equation 2, this is equation 3. From 3 and 2 you are going to get, from 3 and 2. 2 you are going to get. Okay. So MGR is nothing but L, isn't it? The radius is nothing but L, isn't it? So now what you are going to write down, from this I can write down, I will simplify this equation. So let it be, that implies I will bring this. So MGL is equal to MVC square. No, that is equation 3. So from 2 and 3, MVC square is MGL, MVC square is MGL. So EC is equal to how much? Half into MVC square is MGL plus 2MGL. 2MGL and this. How much MGL? That is nothing but total. Okay. That is 4 plus 5 by 2 MGL. EC which is equal to 5 by 2 MGL. Okay. But we know that this is 4. Okay, this is 4. So we got that, we got that from 3, MM cancels and I can write down VC square which is equal to GL and VC which is equal to square root of GL. So what is the velocity of what here? That is nothing but square root of GL. Now since total mechanical energy remains conserved, no? Since total mechanical energy remains conserved, since energy is conserved, EC must be equal to EA. EC must be equal to EA. So what I can write down? So EC is nothing but 5 by 2. MGL is equal to half MVA square. MM cancels, 2 cancels. So VA square which is equal to 5GL and VA is equal to square root of 5GL. And this is the velocity of what? That is in the square root of 5GL. Now what is the velocity attained when it reaches to, when it reaches to B? Now I want to erase some of the equations. Okay, I'll erase here itself. Okay. So this is the energy, this is the velocity. Now at point it was 2MGL. At point C, what is the total energy? Potential energy is, kinetic energy is half MVB square plus potential energy is how much? MGL. It is raised to this height, no? This height and this height. This means 2L, this means L. So what you can get? EB and EC also you can write down, since conservation, no, EB is equal to EC, conservation you can write down. So half MVB square plus MGL is equal to 5 by 2 MGL plus goes there minus half MVB square which is equal to 2, 5 by minus 2 is 3 by 2 MGL. So MM cancels, 2 cancels, VB square which is equal to 3GL and VB is equal to square root of 3GL. So you are going to get here 3GL square root of. Now we don't want this. Okay. I may erase this. Okay. I hope all of you have written or you were waiting me for at the last to write. But it is not that much of, you know, necessary. You can write and buy at it. Don't do that. It's just understanding. Okay. You require only this much. Nothing derivation is necessary here. But the concept what we have done, that is important. They won't ask this derivation for the examination. But remember, potential energy equal to kinetic energy. The total force, net force we have written. And the object is there, reaches, what is the velocity, all those things. That is, now my question is, why we have done this? Why we have done this? Because velocity we found. What was our aim? Our aim was that if I give the velocity and it is maximum, means it will rotate like anything. Now my aim is there, aim is that I have to give minimum velocity. I have to give minimum velocity in such a way that I have to give minimum velocity in such a way that it just moves and reaches here and comes back. Just moves, reaches there and comes back. Just moves, reaches there and comes back means that is, it object goes, decreases velocity, decreases, and completely becomes less and come back. No, actually it is not going to become less. So to be to that velocity has to go here and it has to slacken and has to, see, it will go like this. Like this it will fall. Half circle it will complete. No. So some velocity is there. After that it becomes zero. You can just do that experiment. Theoretical we are doing. So minimum velocity you must give this much. If the velocity given less than this, it does not going to complete half circle. If it is more than this, it will complete one full circle. If it is equal to this, it will go, when it attains to this exactly half of that, it will attain 3gl, and after that it will go root gl and it come back like that. Now again my question is, where we are using this, where we are using this concepts in day to day life, okay? So which is very much useful for us, where it is? So I will give you an example. All of you have done this, but you don't know and you have not used that. This concept was involved there, you didn't know. Now you are going to get to know. Take a bucket filled with water. Now you take that bucket and give large velocity. When it goes up like this, water will spills back, no? With the less velocity means, but with the maximum velocity means it won't fill because of this. If the more this much velocity is given, then water won't spill or come, you know, fall down. If it is less than this velocity means it will fall. You might have seen a bike rider moving in a vertical cycle. In the circus, they are moving in a vertical circle. In a death well, a bike rider will move, a bicycle will move. This velocity must be more than this. This velocity must be more than this. Otherwise, the bike rider or the car or the vehicle who is performing the stunt may receive or may got arm, but he has to use the physics in a right way. That is physics. That's why more velocity they have to use always, or else the minimum velocity that must be for which that vertical circle they are going to draw or they are going to cover. If it is less than that means this will be the case, they will fall. Or if it is more than that means they are going to cover the circle. That is what. So a lot of cases this vertical circle motion we are using in our day to day life. You have observed everything you had done, but today you understood that this is the concept behind this stunts. Okay, and I can say that this is the physics behind all the performance, right? That's why the minimum velocity is that much you must use. Now if I ask that, and you may have questions that is that derivation I have to go through it, is that derivation I have to buy out? No, don't do that, not necessary. But this diagram you have to write down. After that, these things you have to write down, and motion in a vertical circle you have to write down. The minimum velocity for an object to complete one circle must be given, that is at the bottom this square root of LGL, and which is very very important for your competitive exams. So if your the circle is moving in this way, the tension will be always in this way, and mg will be in this way, and there is one more force, that is centripetal force mu square by r. Always we are writing net force is equal to m into a. The net force is how much? The net force is actually this mu square by r. In that direction tension is there, okay, but in the opposite direction mg is there. This is what this equation you are writing, which you have studied in your laws of motion, okay, which you have studied in your laws of motion, like this. So that is called free body diagram. So laws of motion, already you have discussed these things, that is for competitive exams are very much necessary. Now I am going to erase this, go through it, go through the formulas, go through the things, okay. So as of now, for today, this much is sufficient. Thank you very much.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.